Welcome to the section Solving Equations Using Maxima. In mathematics, to solve an equation means to find a solution which are the values that fulfill the condition stated by the equation. When finding a solution, one or more variables may be as unknowns. A solution is the value to the unknown variable that make the equality true in the given equation. A solution is also called the root of the equation. An equation can be solved either numerically or symbolically. So the methods for finding the equation roots generally depends on the type of the given equation. There are different types of equations in mathematics, such as polynomial equations, trigonometric equations, system of linear equations, etc. Similarly, there are so many methods to solve these types of equations. Factorization method, substitution method, matrix method, etc. Here, in this video, I'm going to discuss how Maxima helps to solve different types of equations using the Maxima functions. First one, exact solution of one equation. Here, we are dealing with one equation in one unknown variable. The general form is solve in bracket. We want to give the expression comma the unknown variable x, or solve in bracket just the expression without the unknown variable. Okay, this solves the algebraic expression for the variable x and returns a list of solution in x. If the given expression is not an equation, then Maxima itself assumed it as an equation. Here, the expression may be a rational one and may contain trigonometric functions, etc. Okay, let's see some examples. First example, I'm going to solve the second degree polynomial equation. That is x square minus 1 equal to 0. So, the syntax is solve in brackets. We want to give the expression, then the unknown variable. So, x square minus 1 equal to 0, comma, here x is the unknown variable. So, x gives the answer, x equal to minus 1, x equal to 1. Next, the same problem with another syntax, that is solve in brackets x square minus 1 equal to 0. Here, the unknown variable is absent. So, let's see the example, x equal to minus 1, x equal to 1, similar to the previous answer. Next, the same problem with another form, solve in bracket just the expression, x square minus 1, which is not in the equation form. So, solve x square minus 1 also gives the answer as x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 1. So, these three forms gives the solution to the equation x square minus 1 equal to 0. Next problem, solve in bracket x square minus a equal to 0. Here, I didn't give the unknown variable. Let's see what's the answer. It executes an error, which means solve more unknown than equations. Here, in equation x square minus a equal to 0, there are two unknowns, x and a. So, we want to specify which variable is the unknown variable. Then only Maxima executes the answer. Okay, if there are more than one unknown variable, then we want to specify for what variable we want the answer. So, solve x square minus a equal to 0, comma, here I am giving the unknown variable x. Then it gives the answer as x equal to minus root a, x equal to root a. Okay, then the same problem with the next form, solve x square minus a, comma, x, here the expression which is not in the form of an equation. Then also it returns the answer x equal to minus root a, x equal to root a. Okay, next we are going to solve some quadratic equations. Same form, solve in bracket, I am giving the quadratic equation a into x square plus b into x plus c comma x gives the answer as x equal to minus b plus or root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Next problem, solve 3 star x square plus 7 star x minus 6 with respect to x gives the answer x equal to minus 3 and x equal to 2 by 3. Next one, solve x square plus 1 with respect to x gives x equal to minus I, x equal to I, which is the complex roots. Next, moving to cubic equations, which means third degree polynomial equations. Same form, solve 6 x cube minus 4 5 star x square minus 17 star x plus 6 equal to 0 with respect to x gives the answer x equal to minus 3 by 2, 1 by 3 and 2. Third degree equations which have 3 roots. Next problem, solve x cube plus x square minus 16 star x equal to 16 with respect to x gives the value x equal to 4 minus 1 minus 4. Solve x cube minus x minus 1. Unknown variable x gives the answer as this one. The 3 roots are here. Next is solve x cube minus 1 with respect to x gives the answer the 3 roots. Next example, here I am going to solve a rational equation, that is solve in bracket x power 2 plus 1 divided by x minus 1. Here the expression is a rational function. The unknown variable is x. Gives the answer x. X equal to minus I. X equal to I. Next also rational equation. Solve x divided by x plus 1 plus x minus 1 divided by x. Gives the answer x equal to minus 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2. Next, I am giving a bi-quadratic equation, that is fourth degree polynomial. Solve x power 4 minus x power 2 minus 2 equal to 0. Unknown variable x gives the value x equal to minus I, x equal to I minus root 2, root 2. Next, for the fifth degree polynomial, solve 6 star x power 5 minus x power 4 minus 43 star x power 3 plus 43 star x square plus x minus 6. Unknown variable x gives the answer minus 1 by 3 minus 3, 1 by 2, 1, 2. Next, let's see what about the higher degree polynomial. Here I am giving the 8th degree polynomial. Solve 3 star x power 8 minus x cube plus x plus 1 unknown variable x gives the answer the equation itself, which means higher order polynomial cannot be solved using the command solve. For higher order polynomial equations, we need the another maxima function. Okay, let it discuss in the next section. Next problem, solve 1.1 star x square minus x minus 1 equal to 0. Here the coefficient of x square is a decimal value, that is 1.1. in the previous examples we does not give any decimal value as the coefficient. Let's see what about the decimal coefficient equation. Here the rational replaced 1.1 by 11 by 10, which means here by using the maxima function solve, the decimal forms all are replaced by rational form and the answers will be executed in the rational form. Okay, that is Here 1.1 is replaced by 11 by 10 and gave the answer in the decimal form. Okay, these are the examples of using maxima function solve. Next, we are moving to numerical solution of polynomials using the function all roots. It's similar to the function solve. Here, this computes the numerical approximation of the real and complex roots of the polynomial equation of one variable. Also, this function will help us to solve higher degree polynomials also. Okay, the syntax is all roots in bracket. We want to give it the expression. Let's see example. All roots in bracket, I am giving a fifth degree equation. 3 star x power 5 plus 2 star x square minus x minus 1 gives the 5 roots of the equation, which contains complex values, real values, etc. All the values are in the decimal form. So all roots function executes the answer in floating points. Okay, next I am giving the example all roots of the previous problem in solve 1.1 x square minus x minus 1 equal to 0. While using the maxima function solve, we get the rational answers. Let's see what about for all roots. So all roots of 1.1 x square minus x minus 1 equal to 0 gives the two values in the decimal form. So this is the difference between the command solve and all roots. Next, I am going to find the root of an 8th degree polynomial. So all roots of x power 8 plus 1 gives the 8 roots of the equation in the decimal form. So this is the examples for the command all roots. Next maxima function, find underscore root. It is mainly for solving the transcendental equations. Transcendental equation means it's an equation which containing the logarithmic exponential functions. Also, trigonometric functions are also sometimes considered as transcendental equations. For solving these types of equation, we use the function find underscore root. So the syntax is find underscore root in bracket. We want to give the expression, comma, the unknown variable, also the intervals a comma b. That is, this finds the root of the given equation over the closed interval a b. So here we want to specify the intervals also. So the examples are find underscore root of x square minus 1 equal to 0. It is the equation, comma, unknown variable x. Here I am going to find the root in the closed interval 0 to. So lower limit, upper limit. So 0, 2 gives the answer 1.0. So 1.0 is the one root lies between 0 and 2. Similarly, find underscore root. Here I am going to find what is the solution of e raised to x equal to 3. So e raised to x is represented by exp of x equal to 3, unknown variable x, over the interval 0 to. Answer 1.098, this one. Okay, next I am going to find the solution of sin x equal to x in the interval 0 pi. So find underscore root, expression sin of x equal to x, unknown variable x, comma, 0, comma, percent pi, which is for pi, gives the answer 0. Okay, these are the maxima functions to solve one equation in one variable. Next, we are moving to solutions of more than one variable. Solutions of more than one variable and more than one equation. First example, here also the maxima function is solve. Here I am going to find the solution of x square minus y square equal to a square and x plus y equal to b. Here there are two equations with two unknowns. Okay, so solve in bracket. If there are more than one variable, what to do? We want to list them in square brackets. So here I am going to give or solve two equations. So in square brackets, x power 2 minus y power 2 equal to a power 2, comma, next equation, x plus y equal to b, comma. Here, what are the unknowns? X and y. So more than one value, so we want to put it in square bracket. Then again square bracket, the variables x comma y gives the answer x equal to b square plus a square divided by 2b and y equal to b square minus a square divided by 2b. If n equations are in n unknowns, results in the unique solution. So here two equations with the two unknowns, so we have unique solutions for x and y. Next example, I am going to solve one equation but it has two variables. Okay, problem is solve x plus y equal to 3, one equation, comma, here there are two unknowns, so list them in brackets, square bracket, x comma y. Let's see what is the result. Here x equal to 3 minus percent r1, y equal to percent r1. Here percent r1 is the arbitrary constants introduced by maxima, because in mathematics, if number of equations is less than number of unknowns, then it didn't give a unique solution. So for getting the solution, we want to give an arbitrary value to some variables. That is, if m equations are there with n unknowns, then we want to give arbitrary value to n minus m variables. That is, here one equation with two unknowns, so we want to give arbitrary value to 2 minus 1 variables, that is one variable. So here the arbitrary value is taken to y, so y equal to percent r1, which is a arbitrary constant. So when y equal to percent r1, then x equal to 3 minus percent r1, or otherwise when x equal to percent r1, y equal to 3 minus percent r1. Next problem, here I am going to solve x square minus y square minus z equal to 0, comma, 2 star x plus y plus z equal to 1. Here two equations are there and there are three unknown variables. So, comma, in closed bracket, x comma y comma z gives the values as this one. Here there are two set of values. If x equal to percent r2, then y and z are in terms of percent r2. Another set of solutions, when x equal to percent r3, then y and z in terms of percent r3. This is the solution. Next, we are moving to solutions of linear system of equations. If we have some linear system of equations, then how to solve? Same as above problems, but the command is different. Here the command is LIN solve. LIN means linear system of equations. Okay, so LIN solve, in bracket we want to list the equations: 2 star x plus y plus z equal to 1, 3 star x minus y plus 2 star z equal to 4, x minus y plus z equal to 5. Here three unknowns, comma, in square brackets, x, y, z gives unique values because three equations with three unknowns. So x equal to minus 8, y equal to 2, z equal to 15. This problem is, it can also be done with the command solve. Okay, next problem, LIN solve. Here two equations, two unknowns, so the result will be unique solution. X plus y equal to 5, x minus y equal to 3, and the variables are x, y. Gives the answer x equal to 4 and y equal to 1. Okay. Next, moving to the matrix method. In matrix method, a linear system of equations are given, then we want to convert it into a matrix form. Here I am going to solve two equations, 3x minus y equal to 4 minus x plus y equal to 2. Okay, so I want to represent these two equations in a matrix. So let's see what to do here. M colon matrix in bracket, square bracket 3 minus 1, then again minus 1, 1. If you are given two equations, then convert it into a matrix form. First of all, we want to find the coefficient matrix. Coefficient matrix means here the coefficient of x, 3, here minus 1, here coefficient of y, minus 1, 1. So, in matrix form, first of all, we want to write the coefficient matrix. So, here 3, minus 1, and the second row, minus 1, 1. Then, the variables, that is x, y, that is equal to, again the matrix 4, 2, that is the matrix form. So, first of all, we want to give the coefficient matrix. I am assigning the matrix by M. So, M colon matrix in bracket give the first row, that is 3, comma minus 1, that is the coefficients in the first equation, comma, next, second row, minus 1, 1, that is the coefficients of the second equation. So, gives the matrix 3 minus 1 minus 1 1. Then, in the equations, the RHS of equal to sign is 4 and 2. Then, we want to represent it by a matrix. Then, another matrix B colon 4 comma 2 gives the answer 4 2. In matrix method, the solving maxima command is a linear system of equations. Okay, so lin solve underscore by underscore lu in brackets m comma b, because it's a linear system of equations. So lin solve by matrix method, so underscore by underscore lu in brackets, we want to specify the matrices, that is m comma b, gives the answer as this one. That is, first a column vector 3, 5, and the second list it has false. Means the first element, which is the column vector 3, 5, is the answers. That is x equal to 3 and y equal to 5. The second list is false, returned as false, because here the calculations uses non-floating point numbers. Therefore, it gives the second element as false. If floating point calculations are used, then the second element will be either false or lower bound to the matrix condition number. Okay. Next, again by matrix method, going to solve the two equations, x plus y equal to 2, 2x minus y equal to 3. First of all, we want to make the coefficient matrix. So, M colon matrix, first row, the coefficient of the first equation, that is 1, 1, comma, second equation, the coefficients are 2, minus 1. So, second row, 2, minus 1, gives 1, 1, 2, minus 1. Then, the constants in the RHS is 2 and 3. So, B colon 2, 3, gives 2, 3. Then, solving command, lin solve underscore by underscore lu in bracket the matrix m comma b gives the answer 5 by 3, 1 by 3, which is the answers for x and y, and the second list as false, which means non-floating point numbers is numbers calculations are done here. Okay. Thank you.